Use the properties of real numbers to rewrite and simplify each expression. State which properties apply. Let's begin by reviewing the properties of real numbers. First, we have the commutative property of addition and the commutative property of multiplication. The commutative property of addition is when we change the order of a sum, which states a plus b equals b plus a. The commutative property of multiplication is when we change the order of multiplication, which states a times b equals b times a. Next, we have the associative property, which deals with grouping. The associative property of addition states a times the quantity b plus c equals the quantity a plus b plus c. When we change the grouping of a sum, we are using the associative property. The associative property of multiplication states a times bc equals ab times c. When we change the grouping of multiplication, we are using the associative property. Next is the distributive property, which states a times the quantity b plus c equals a times b plus a times c. The distributive property is often referred to as multiplication across addition. Next is the identity property of addition and of multiplication. The identity property of addition states there exists a unique real number called the additive identity 0, such that for any real number, a plus 0 equals a. The identity property of multiplication states there exists a unique real number called the multiplicative identity 1, such that for any real number a times 1 equals a. And then finally, we have the inverse property of addition and the inverse property of multiplication. The inverse property of addition states every real number a has an additive inverse or opposite denoted negative a or the opposite of a, such that a plus negative a equals 0. The inverse property of multiplication states every non-zero real number a has a multiplicative inverse or reciprocal denoted 1 over a, such that a times 1 over a equals 1. So going back to our example, looking at expression 1, let's begin simplifying by clearing the parentheses by distributing the 4 using the distributive property. Distributing the 4, we have 4 times 7 plus 4 times 5. And again, this is the distributive property. The next step in simplifying is to determine the products. 4 times 7 equals 28, 4 times 5 equals 20, and 28 plus 20 equals 48. For the next expression, notice how 9 and negative 9 are opposites, and therefore let's change the grouping of this sum. Let's group the 9 plus negative 9 instead of the 3 plus 9. Changing the grouping of addition is the associative property of addition. So the given expression is equal to 3 plus the quantity 9 plus negative 9. This is the associative property of addition. And now let's find the sum of the opposites inside the parentheses. 9 plus negative 9 is equal to 0. This is the inverse property of addition. And 3 plus 0 is equal to 3. Adding 0 is the identity property of addition. The given expression simplifies to 3. Next, we have 8 minus the quantity 11 plus 6. To begin simplifying, let's clear the parentheses. Because of the subtraction, we clear the parentheses by distributing negative 1. To make this more obvious, let's write the given expression as a sum. 8 minus the quantity 11 plus 6 is equivalent to the expression 8 plus negative 1 times the quantity 11 plus 6. In this form, it's much more obvious to clear the parentheses, we distribute negative 1. So distributing, we have 8 plus negative 1 times 11 plus negative 1 times 6. This is the distributive property. Now we simplify by determining the products. So we have 8 plus negative 1 times 11 is negative 11. We can write plus negative 11 or just minus 11. Let's go ahead and write plus negative 11 plus negative 1 times 6 equals negative 6. So we can write plus negative 6 or minus 6. Let's write plus negative 6. And now we simplify. 8 plus negative 11 is negative 3. Negative 3 plus negative 6 equals negative 9. The given expression simplifies to negative 9. Next we have 3/4 times the product of 7/9 and 4/3. Well, 3/4 and 4/3 are reciprocals, and therefore, let's change the order of this product inside the parentheses using the commutative property of multiplication. That way we'll have the 3/4 and 4/3 next to each other. So the given expression equals 3/4 times the quantity 4/3 times 7/9 due to the commutative property of multiplication. And now let's change the grouping of the product. Let's group the 3/4 and 4/3, which are reciprocals. This is an example of the associative property of multiplication. So the expression is equal to the quantity 3/4 times 4/3 times 7/9 due to the associative property of multiplication. And now determine the product of the reciprocals. 3/4 times 4/3 equals 1, which is the inverse property of multiplication. From here, we know 1 times 7/9 equals 7/9. But because multiplying by 1 is an example of the identity property of multiplication, let's first change the order of this multiplication using the commutative property of multiplication, and then we'll use the identity property of multiplication. So the given product 1 times 7/9 is equal to 7/9 times 1 due to the commutative property of multiplication. And then 7/9 times 1 is equal to 7/9. Multiplying by 1 is an example of the identity property of multiplication. Of course, we would not go through all these steps to simplify the given expression, but this is a nice way to demonstrate many of the properties of real numbers. Let's look at our last example. We have 100 times the quantity 0.23 plus negative 1.78. We will begin by clearing the brackets or grouping symbols by distributing the 100, and therefore we use the distributive property. The given expression is equal to 100 times 0.23 plus 100 times negative 1.78. And again, this is the distributive property. And now we simplify by determining the products. 100 times 0.23 equals 23. So we have 23 plus 100 times the negative 1.78 equals negative 178. Now we find the sum. 23 plus negative 178 equals negative 155. The given expression simplifies to negative 155. I hope you found this helpful.